She had suffered for 12 years and had spent all she had searching for a cure. Then one day, in an act of faith, this woman from Galilee quietly reached out to touch the hem of Christ's robe. She was instantly healed. The robe was just a piece of cloth. Yet when Christ was present, there flowed a great healing power. As we gather here today, this could be just another choral presentation, but we pray that the Spirit of Christ will live in our words and music as we invite you to come. Come, encounter the presence and power of Christ. Come, touch the robe.
Come to this side, O Lord.
Through the robe, she experienced Christ's compassion and healing. Later, on a mountain, the robe reflected his holiness and power. Jesus took three of his disciples up the mountain and was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became white as the light. Moses and Elijah appeared with him, and a voice came from a cloud saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." Certainly, this was a powerful encounter for the disciples. His shining robe and the voice from the cloud burned into their memories. Though they would face many difficult days, these memories would give them tremendous confidence as they preached the Lordship and Gospel of Christ. The glory and authority of Christ were dramatically revealed on the mountain. Later, when Jesus and his disciples entered Jerusalem, the cloaks of the people were used to proclaim his glory. A large crowd spread their cloaks and palm branches on the road. They formed a procession and shouted, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!" The whole city was stirring and asked, "Who is this man?" The crowd answered, "This is Jesus, the prophet from Nazareth."
Many were wondering if this could really be their new king. Others had already witnessed Christ's power and shouted, "Blessed is the King of Israel!
Hosanna! Hosanna! He's the King of Israel! Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes! Hosanna! Hosanna! He's the King of Israel! Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes! In the name of the Lord!"
I heard he can raise the dead, is it true? True.
Oh yes, I saw it. He called out to the angry waves, "Peace be still," and we were saved.
We were saved.
He answered, "Saved
to save
all people." Shout, "Hosanna! Hosanna! He is the King of Israel! Hosanna! Hosanna! Blessed is he who comes! Hosanna! Hosanna!
Soon afterward, Jesus and his disciples gathered in an upper room to share the Passover meal. After witnessing the events of the week, the disciples were now certain Jesus would be their new king. What happened next left them wondering what kind of king he would be. After the Passover meal, he rose and laid aside his garments. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the feet of the disciples. Jesus removed his robe to take on the form of a servant. His clothes had conveyed healing and had reflected heaven's glory. But now, his robe was laid aside to teach the disciples an enduring lesson of humility.
There one night in the upper room, he laid aside his robe. He wrapped a towel around his waist, like a servant's clothes.
And my master, Lord and King, kneeled to do this amazing thing. He washed my feet. He got down on his knees and washed my feet. I would my master, Lord and King, come.
In Philippians, we read that Jesus took upon himself the form of a servant. He humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the excruciating death of the cross. He demonstrated this obedience unto death through his arrest, his trial, and his crucifixion. After he was tried, soldiers mocked him and stripped him of his garment, replacing it with a purple robe. They put a crown of thorns on his head and hailed him as king. But through every step of the way, it was clear he had become the king of suffering.
Come now to the trial of Jesus. Hear the charges and the clear he is an innocent man, still he will be crucified.
At the foot of the cross, soldiers cast lots to see who would take Jesus' robe. As Christ died, the winner held the empty robe in his hand. To the sick woman, it had conveyed healing power. For the disciples on the mountain, it had reflected heaven's glory. But now that Jesus was gone, it was just a piece of cloth. The soldiers hadn't planned to be touched by their encounter with Christ, but at least one of them was changed by what he saw that day. At the moment of Christ's death, he exclaimed, "Surely this was the Son of God."
Soldiers of God.
Jesus' body was laid in a borrowed tomb. The stone was rolled into place. The grave was sealed as his body lay silently wrapped in the shroud of death. But the Bible promises that death has lost its power. O death, where is your sting? O grave, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Come and touch his linen shroud, not to mourn the tragedy of death, but to remember that these grave clothes will soon lay empty, left behind, on the floor of the tomb. Today, we have encountered Christ through the stories of his last days on earth. We have touched his robe of healing. We have seen his shining robe of glory. We have been challenged by his humble clothes of servanthood. We have remembered his purple robe of suffering and felt the linen of his shroud. But we look forward to the day when we will truly see Christ, clothed in the full righteousness and power of heaven.
The book of Revelation tells us that one day we will wear the shining robes of the saints and join all heaven to proclaim the marvelous glory of the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb. sing.